So for this video, goal number one, we are going to attempt to create an aircraft that will fly to the North Pole without leaving the atmosphere. This guy is not going to do it. He's only got two fuel tanks, and each one of these fuel tanks has only a 150 capacity. And the burn rate on our engine is 0.3. So mathematically speaking, that's not far enough. I don't know the numbers, and I don't really care, but I do know that that shit ain't far enough. But I do think we have a decent part setup here to begin with. So what we're going to do is we're going to modify this into a multi-stage plane. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add this little extended pod bank here. Will you get off my mouse, you fucking bastard? Get off my mouse. And this guy here is an airframe fuselage. It does have fuel in it, though not very much. It's got about half the fuel that is in this Mark II fuselage. So this is going to be the main portion of our aircraft, and we're going to have to create a converter to get it to connect with the rest of that. I don't even know if I'll use any of these parts, but we'll see. So we're going to create a gigantic piece of thing here with a butt end. Actually, that butt end does not fit on this. What you can do is take this and turn it around. You can use the WSAD keys to rotate and put these at all angles. And so there's going to be the main portion of our space plane. And I'm going to connect this briefly for now. Obviously, proportionally speaking, that does not look correct. It's because it is not correct. Let's go ahead and throw that out there. So what we need to do is create a large wing structure on here. We're going to do that by putting multiple wings together in harmony. Not necessarily harmony for now. They're just going to be multiple wings. Because we need to create a very big wing. Or if you're Trogdor, a very big wing-a-ling. And each one of those wings there is going to have its own control surface. Let's try going with just two. I don't want to get crazy and have three on there because it's not really necessary. And then we will copy that. I'm not going to copy that. I'm just going to clone it. I'll mirror it, I suppose is the word. There we go. We'll put those right here. Now, one of the other things I added with this is you can look at the center of lift, center of thrust, and center of gravity. And you want to have your wings pretty close to the center of gravity. But this ship type and shape is going to change. For example, I'm actually going to rip this completely off here. And we'll put this guy right here. And so that'll move the center of gravity a little bit further up. These wings are not going to be enough with this fuel pod as it is to get us completely going. So one of the things we're going to do is we're going to rip off this control section from the back here. And I may actually, let's just toss this completely out. So we've got a whole new ship here. We need to name this guy. We'll name him Pole Rubber Mark 1. There we go. Now we've got something to rub the pole. Mark 1. And I'll move the wings back just a little bit so that they're a little bit more in line with that center of gravity and center of lift. Alright, so that's interesting. Now, we're going to put some canards on the front of this guy, because that'll give us a lot more control when flying. And then at the back of here, we're going to have to put some more canards, but I don't like how close they are to the rear end of this thing. So let's see if we can add a little structure to attach them to. Like we could do this, and then attach the canards to that. Which looks a little weird, but in function, it will work pretty well. And we need a vertical stabilizer. So for that, we're going to do a similar idea here. Putting that here, and then putting a canard on that. You can use other types of things, but I find using canards and other things to be pretty damn effective, so I'm not going to mess with it. I'm not going to fuck with the formula that works. That looks ridiculously silly, but I think it will probably maybe work a little bit. I hope. So I'm going to move these landing pieces over here. Please? No, that's not the right way. There we go. And we're actually going to rotate them a little bit so that they're pointing forward. I hope. That's not quite forward. Come on. This is a bitch right here. Give me the piece. Give me the piece. Nobody ever said it was perfect. Okay, is that pointed forward? No, it's not. They're cockeyed a little bit. Damn it! Damn it, damn it, damn it. Like I said, I'm great at this. Okay. I don't know if that's... It feels cockeyed. It still feels a little... No, I think that's correct. That might even be inward. We'll burn that bridge when we come to it. Okay, so we need to create a landing gear for the front of this guy here. And we'll just put it up here. No need for mirroring. And hopefully that will allow us to take off. Although I don't like how the axis of rotation is going to affect this engine on takeoff. I suppose what we ought to do is just take this guy out and see what it can do. Let's clear the runway because Bill is still sitting there on his decapitated plane. Or Bob or whatever. And it's not tipping over yet. We're going to turn up the thrust and see what this thing can do aerodynamically speaking. I didn't mean to do what I just did. I forgot to set up the stages. I still haven't covered this because I keep forgetting. But move that. Damn it. Okay, so I guess we're going to cover that now. Because I always forget to do that. And that will be a continuing problem. So these are the stages. You can create various stages. When you press spacebar, it executes a stage and then moves to the next. So this is stage 3. We're going to want our engine to be on the first stage. So we'll move that down there. These are decouplers. You can tell by the little icon there. These are the landing gear. These are the wings. These are the fuel tanks. We want our decouplers to be the next stage because there is no other effective stage. When these decouple, it's these guys right here, and they'll pop off these landing gears. So I don't actually really want to do that, but I need to have them on their own separate stage. And then, for now, all we're going to have is a one-stage deal that will launch this guy by turning on the engine. So now we've got the engine in the right spot, and we can start with that instead of having it finish last after we've jettisoned our frickin' landing gear. All right, so we'll turn on that, and we're going to start the process of taking off. Already going a little weird on the runway here, probably due to my wheels being poorly organized. But hey, we've achieved flight. It's a bit wonky. But here we are. Alright, now we can throttle all the way up. And I'm going to trim this guy out just a smidge. Please, please trim out. There we go. Alright, we're flying the wrong direction right now. We're actually flying out this way. But we need to be flying this way. And I just want to use this as a way to find out what kind of fuel capacity we're working with. We don't have any of the extra fuel pods that we're going to need. I think we need to fly that way. Bob is screaming. All right, so the more I climb, I'm actually losing efficiency. So we need to go down a little bit. We're going to try and reduce our altitude to probably about 2,500 meters, maybe. This is going to change, and you just want to try to react to it. It's still going down, but we're now losing altitude slowly. You don't want to make any drastic changes, because that could be really inefficient on your fuel, because if you start changing your flight path, you'll have to recorrect and then lose a lot of that fuel efficiency. So, some minor incremental changes. Still at 85, we'll see where we can get to a better fuel efficiency at. Okay, that appears to have all been for naught because we've changed our altitude quite a bit and we're only up to 8.6%. So maybe this thing's really for low altitude. We're going to try to get to around 2,000 because I think that was where I had 0.87. And then we'll carry on from there. Oh, hey, we're at 2,000, 0.87. All right, bring it up. Bring it up a smidge. And there we go. We're not quite pointed north. So I'm going to recorrect our course just a bit. But we have made so much progress, it's not even funny. We're 71 kilometers away, and we are about a quarter of the... Actually, less than a quarter, maybe like an eighth of the way through our fuel, if I'm correct. Although math is not my strong suit. In fact, nothing's my strong suit. I don't have one. I don't even have a suit. I guess I'm a joker. Ha! That was a joke! Now I'll just add a fart at the end of it. There we go. Super funny. With me! Okay, so I did a little more testing. Looks like 0.88 at about 1600 meters is going to be our money spot. Somewhere around 1700 meters. I might be able to go lower and get more, but I don't really feel comfortable considering all the mountain ranges and stuff. So we're just going to carry on here and see what we can achieve. Maybe even modifying the thrust will get us better efficiency, but I don't think so. 88% efficiency is pretty damn good, though. I'm not really going to mess with that too much. I don't want to start. I'm starting to lose altitude, so I'm going to trim up a bit. And we're just going to carry on from here. They added something else neat with this version of Kerbal Space Program. Trees! Well, you know, sort of. And I forgot to use the cockpit for the rest of this, because I'm really not used to it. It's such a new feature that it's something that I'm not really familiar with. But we can actually use this to fly successfully to where we're going. There's our altitude, and we have our vertical speed, which is not very high. Good, because we're not going vertically. And then we have our surface speed, which is 137 meters per second. We could be going a lot faster, but our throttle's only at about 50% right now. Trying to be fuel efficient. Okay, we're officially halfway out of fuel, or halfway through our fuel. We've used this and this, and now we have this and this left. So we're not going to make it. We're going to make it to about here. And I'm going to go ahead and see if I can land it there, just to leave a little marker of where we are and have been. I'm not really flying level here, but whatever. We're still making good progress, and we're going to continue to do so. Alright, we are now on to our last little mini fuel pod, and we are nearly out of fuel. This is all that's left. There's no way we're coming home, so no need to panic, like Bob is doing. And I'm not jettisoning him from the aircraft, so it's going to be tough to land in these trees. Hopefully it ends right there. We're not going to make it to these mountains like I thought we were. We're probably going to end up somewhere around there. And then we can adjust our vehicle accordingly. Okay, we can actually start to see the snowy tops of those mountains off in the distance, but we are very nearly out of fuel. I'm flying at a 4x speed multiplier, so we'll run out of fuel even quicker. But I'm hoping that there will be some end to this forest, because I don't really like the idea of getting lodged in a tree. Well, we have no choice, because now we're out of fuel. Now, hopefully, when we've got this guy landed, we can learn more about the engine's fuel efficiency, etc., and then make some changes to the aircraft to make it so that we can actually make it to the North Pole, and then after that we can worry about trying to get back. But for now, this has been a really successful first flight for a first large aircraft. Unfortunately, I'm going so slow right now, I'm going to have to put it down somewhere around here. Let's go ahead and start rolling over for landing. We'll put our gear down. I don't think I can do this in the cockpit because of all the terrain changes around here. I'm going to want to trim up quite a bit. Oh boy. Not going quite slow enough yet. Yeah, I don't like landing on these hills, especially with all these trees around. But we don't have any fuel, so we don't have a choice. Oh boy. Don't buckle. I'm not going to start hitting the brakes until those guys stop bending. I'm thinking we're okay. Alright, and there it is. We've made it here! And I do think these wheels are pointed a little inward. I don't know. It's a little tough to tell. But here we are. We can actually get out and then get back in, except I don't have a ladder on here, so we couldn't get back in. So I'm going to leave Bob in here. And we are going to go back to the Space Center, and we'll take a look at the tracking station. And now we can see we have Jebediah here at the Kerbal Space Center. And then we have Pole Rubber Mark 1. Made it almost halfway to the pole. It'd be easier to go to the South Pole, because Kerbal Space Center is closer to that, I believe. I don't think it's exactly at the median, but it might be. I don't know. But we made it probably 40% of the way to where we want to go. So, we got a lot of work to do. So I'm really happy with our stability and our control surfaces, but we do need to make it more efficient, and we need to figure out about the altitude, etc. I think we're just going to go with more of the same engines here. And what we can do is we can add some more jettisonable fuel pods along with these as well. And I need to make sure that we're going to have to do some testing around the Space Center to make sure it's safe to jettison these, because they could just smash into the wings if I'm not careful. I may have to perform some sort of jettisoning maneuver to get them off there safely. I do want to see here, this has got a capacity of 150, this has got a capacity of 400. So these are very large fuel tanks here. So what we're going to do is we're going to modify the stages. I want to use these guys at one stage, this guy at another stage, and we're going to use some solid boosters at a yet another stage. So we're going to add these solid boosters right here under the wings. Hopefully we can get away with that. These are gigantic. I don't think we're going to be using these. Yeah, those are fucking huge. There's got to be a smaller one. Not really. There's these. I don't think that these will give us enough thrust, let alone... Yeah, they might be low enough. I don't know. I think it might be worth a try, just to see what we can come up with these. Plus, I can show you a little bit about the stages while we do this. So we'll test it like that. All right, so stages. We want to fire these solid engines first to hopefully get us off the ground. Then we're going to fire these guys off. And when we decide that they are running out of usefulness, I'm not going to connect these. I don't want them drawing fuel from these main tanks. They're going to be self-sustained. If I was running just these two engines and not this one, then I could consider doing that. Or if I wanted to run all three of them, but I don't think that's necessary. We're going to want these on separate stages. Because this one seems pretty efficient on its own. So we'll do that. We're going to have these guys fire, then we'll have these guys fire, and then we'll get to our last engine. So currently our last engine is firing first, and we don't want that. We're going to want these solid fuel boosters to go first. Make a new stage for this engine. We're actually going to switch these out. All right. Now these guys, we want to jettison them when we're done. So we need to collect their couplers. If you select them here, you'll see them highlight on the right-hand side right here. So now, when we fire the first stage, these guys will ignite. When we fire the second stage, these guys will ignite, and this will pop off at the same time. And with our third stage, we're going to want to pop these guys off. So where is that? Here it is. There's one. Where's the other one? It's right here. Okay, so now when we fire this engine, these two guys will pop off. And then that'll be the final stage. We can still pop off the landing gear, which I don't have any plan to do, but it's possible. So let's take a look at our center of mass. Still good by the wing. Center of lift is a little bit further back. And we're going to give this a go and see if these solid boosters can get us safely off the ground. This is going to be the Pole Rubber Mark II. Oops. Two. There we go. Launch. Now we have Hallie Kerman, because Bob is still... What the fuck was that? Bob is still up here with the Pole Rubber Mark I. I don't know what the hell just flew off, but I'm already thinking that this guy looks pretty cool. Now, solid stage boosters first. Not a lot of ground clearance there. Not a lot at all. I guess we're just going to have to hope for the best. Oh my goodness. Oh my... Hallie, you are fucking dead. Unless you get really lucky. Wow. Hallie's loving it. Look at Hallie. She's like, yeah. Yeah. Okay, so we did a flip. And most of our plane blew up. So maybe those solid boosters are not in the right spot. Let's go and re-engineer this slightly. Yeah, there's just too much thrust. Just too much thrust. Wow, how did you survive that, Jurger? Okay, Hallie's dead. Jurger is still alive. He's also happy about all this chaos. All right, we'll try just one initial thruster. Because so far, two has been a recipe for dead. It actually is touching the ground. And it just exploded. Okay, you know what? Let's just go to the next stage. And we'll see what we can do with these top engines here. Let's see if it'll even fly. It's giving me a lot of downward thrust. Okay. That sure as hell doesn't look good. Fuck. I'm thinking that those little pylons there, it needs to be strapped down. So let's get some strapping stuff. This is space duct tape, by the way. For those of you who are not familiar with the Kerbal Space Program, it allows you to duct tape things together to reduce their flippity floppiness. It's just a structural thing. It allows it to be a lot more stable. I'm not super thrilled about this guy. I don't know if there's anywhere I can put this where it's not going to cause the ship to just blow up when I jettison it. We'll have the two engine configuration, the two stage configuration instead of the three. So these guys go first, and then we'll switch to that one. Let's begin. Now, I'm not too thrilled about how these are giving me downward thrust. I'm not exactly sure why that is. I think it's because this front landing gear is lower than the rear wing landing gear. It's causing the plane to tilt forward. But hey, We've achieved liftoff! It is pretty unstable, but at least these guys aren't flopping around. Now we're going to have to get to... Let's go to about... Oh, wow, these things operate really well at low altitudes. Seriously, 91%? Let's stay around maybe 800 meters. I'm going to need to trim it out. Come on. Wow. 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 This added a lot of weight. A lot of weight. I don't know what the efficiency is going to be on this, as far as, like, how much further than we've already been. All right, Siglis, let's just execute a turn. We'll keep it at around 500 meters for now. Super low altitude plane. Let's go. Let's aim for about 1,000. What's the efficiency? 91. Pretty good. And we're nearly heading north. So we still have good stability here, it seems. Siglis is not happy about that stability, apparently. He likes the plane to be breaking apart or something. This actually seems a little more stable. Maybe not. Actually, horizontally speaking, it's not as stable. Vertically speaking, pretty stable. Okay, so we're losing altitude. Let's trim it up so that that stops. Please. Wow. Okay, we're going to need more thrust out of these because we're actually losing altitude while pointing up. So we're going to need to keep these guys going at a good speed. Oh, hey, he just likes going fast. Maybe not. I don't know. Not anymore. Stop dropping out. Oh, no, I just trimmed the rotation. Why did I do that? Okay, we got it back pretty close to normal. What's our efficiency at? Dropping down to 89%. And we are starting to gain a little bit of altitude. Okay, so let's see how far these guys get us, because we know how far this setup will get us. And anything tacked on from there is just bonus. Alright, so one thing that's looking pretty nice here is that we're still operating at about 88% fuel efficiency, which is going to be the same as about what this one runs at. We're going to need to gain a little altitude because there's a fucking mountain coming up, but we still have about 65% of our fuel left in these two tanks, 248 liters of fuel in these tanks, and we are now 67 kilometers away from base. So about where we would have been if some of these fuels would have already been expended. We're actually going to need to gain a lot of altitude here. Notice that the the altitude system here, it doesn't account for hills. This is sea level that it's talking about here, which is the same altitude as Kerbal Space Center. So not very stable because I accidentally trimmed the rotation, and I don't know how to center that. There might be a control for that. I should probably look, because I'd like it to just be centered, please. In the meantime, we gained enough altitude, and we can keep carrying on. Oh yeah, I forgot. I didn't test whether or not these are going to smash off my wings when I separate them. Okay, Alt-X resets your trim, which is going to point our nose straight down. I shouldn't have done that. I should not have done that. Whoa. Whoops, we're losing altitude pretty quickly here. I probably should have remembered that I had to trim quite a ways up. Okay, but we're not rotatey as we were. We're not quite as rotatey as we were. We need to regain this altitude. That sucks. We lost a little bit of fuel from that. But, come on, bring her up. Bring her on up. Our efficiency will go up a little bit because we're down here. It's actually not that bad. Alright, these guys are about to run out of fuel. Bingo. And I gained a little bit of altitude for this because we're going to need to do this. Tilt pretty much straight up. And then, oh man, that was close. Okay, those have been jettisoned. And now, we are onto our rear engine. We've gone up a little ways in altitude. Our engine's running at pretty good efficiency for right now. That's actually going to change the aerodynamics of the ship a little bit. But, let's see, we can tilt forward just a bit. Come on. How are we doing? Way down in efficiency because we're a little bit too high up. But, we made it. Okole, we didn't quite make it to the Pole Rubber Mark 1 with the Pole Rubber Mark 2. So I don't know if we're going to make it to the pole or not, but I know we didn't have to spend as much fuel out of our main tanks to get here because our takeoff was covered, our altitude gain was covered, and then our cruise was covered as well for quite a ways. So I think that we're in pretty good shape as far as our position to carry on with this. So here we go. More. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, essentially 3 of these fuel tanks left. Cool. We can actually see the Pole Rover Mark 1 now. It is 96 kilometers away on our radar, and we're about halfway through this first fuel tank. The sun is setting on us, so it's starting to get a little dark, which is not super great, but time progresses in real time in this. Whoops, that was a bit of a turn. The Pole Rover Mark 1. There. As far as our fuel goes, whoops, we are less than halfway fuel. Actually, we've got about 100 fuel missing from this guy right here. We actually accidentally turned quite a bit, so that's not going to help us. All right, so these are those mountains that we saw before that we didn't make it to. So I'm actually going to fly around them as opposed to over them to save myself on fuel efficiency, because we've covered the fact that this guy does not perform that great at high altitude. Okay, we are about to run out of fuel. I've gained a little bit of altitude. Bingo, there it goes. Bingo fuel. Gained a little bit of altitude to add to the coast. So we almost doubled the efficiency of the aircraft. But now we're out of fuel and we have to land on more fucking hills. Now we're going at a cruise speed, and we'll go ahead and lower our land. Why is my wing breaking off? Some of the problems that you have when you're in warp time in physics mode is stuff like that, where occasionally something will just break off, so you need to be careful in warp mode, because shit like that will try to happen. Alright, I don't think we're going to be able to land it in cockpit mode, because there's just too much going on around, and it's nighttime. But we are going to set this beast down all the same. Oh boy. I don't want to do it on an uphill slope, so I want to start getting it down right now. I didn't mess with the wheel configuration because the other one worked. Okay, okay, okay. Yep, 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 yep. Tap the brakes, tap the brakes, tap the brakes. Tap the brakes, tap the brakes. And done. Alright, so we made it considerably further than we did before, but we still got a ways to go, so we're going to need to decide if we want to change our SOP so that we go higher altitude, or just add now. We have the Kerbal Space Center, we have the Pole Rover Mark 1, and now we have the Pole Rover Mark 2. The Mark 3, I hope, will get us to the poles, so we can rub them. Alright, so I think part of the problem that we're having is that we're designing this plane as sort of a low-altitude cruise, and I think we'd be best off going for a high-altitude super cruise at high speed. And what we're going to need to do that is switch from these engines to these turbojet engines. The problem is that these have much more fuel in them than these, and so I'm thinking we may use this stage as the initial launch stage, or something else. Maybe we'll add a third stage. And then we'll switch from this to these instead of the other way around. And these will be high altitude turbojets. Because these things you want to keep around 14,000 meters up. Whereas this guy, you don't want to have that high up, I don't think. And this one operates at any altitude, but it consumes fuel like your mom consumes dick. Oh! So I think we're going to rethink this a little bit. And let's see, we need to have an initial launch stage. I think with the added extra stuff that we have here, what's the thrust on this guy? 20. This guy, 250. Isn't there a fucking medium we could get to? Here we go. 120. That's perfect. So we'll see if we can get takeoff easy with detachable solid fuel engines. Put them up. We'll put them on the edges of the wings here. Right about there. And then we will add these guys here. Bingo. They are not pointed in the correct direction, but we can fix that pretty quickly. That's roughly the right direction. Give or take. Mostly take, I think. Yeah, they're not quite right, but it may be good to have them be not quite right. So, let's create a new takeoff stage for these guys. These are our little solid fuel boosters here. I think those are solid fuel. Maybe I should read. Oh, and they're radial mount liquid engines. So they do require fuel, so we are going to have to hook them up to these fuel tanks over here. I was hoping to get a solid fuel engine, but that's not the case. So we're going to draw fuel from those to these. Yes, that's perfect. Well, you know, give or take. I do wish that there was a way that we could make this more efficient, but this is simply too much fuel for us to have this as the takeoff stage. It's just too much fuel. I like having these engines here. I mean, the fact that it can support them is pretty impressive. So I think having these as the high altitude stage is best. So we'll take these guys off and we'll put on the turbojet. But I don't think that... Well, I suppose if we use these to get to the high altitude, then we could switch to this, and then we can also have this one as the high altitude turbojet if these get us to take off. But then we'll have the problem of not being able to get back up, but that's not our issue right now. We're not gonna rub poles with that. So we'll make this the Pole Rubber Mark III. And let's see if this can even take off. Actually, I have to mess with my stages here a little bit. So these will be first stage, and then we'll pop them off. Where's that connector? There it is. We're going to pop them off at stage 3 and begin firing these guys at hopefully a high altitude. So these are going to use the same fuel these do, but these will be more efficient at lower altitudes, I think. It doesn't really say, but I assume that because of the way it looks, it will be more efficient. Okay, so those will pop off, and then we'll fire off these guys here at the same time. And then we'll pop these fellas off. Where's your nodule? There it is. And fire this guy, which is currently way in the wrong position. And then these are our landing gear things. We don't want to have those in a stage at all. All right, so our stages are correct. We have the Pole Rubber Mark III. Let's see if these two new engines can even get us off the ground. That's going to be step one. One other thing I might want to do, as we have Roser Kerman now, is possibly think about adding a stability system to this to make my own flight a little bit easier. We're getting plenty of thrust out of these guys. Fortunately, it's still pointed... Whoa, 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 Roser, I think you might be dead. You know what? Jettison those. Okay. Okay, more thrust. Wow, that was not exactly the takeoff. Roser's loving it, though. He's like, fucking A, dude, you see that? We did a goddamn backflip, bro. Oh, Roser. Okay, so after a disastrous takeoff, we need to take a look and see what the hell is causing these things to be at such a weird thrust vector. More thrust. We're starting to go off the freaking... Damn it. Oh, Roser, you're about to have a bad day. Whoa, Roser, okay. There we go. Oh, bad. Okay, whoa, what is that? What in the fuck is that? Oh, that's not good. Ow. Oh, goodness. What is that? My fucking wing just fell off. Oh, no. Don't do that. No. What have I done? I think that... No, that's perfect. Ish. Okay, so we're going to try to take off again. Because we're devolved to that, to the point where... This thing no longer even fucking flies. That's how much we've over-engineered it. Completely new landing gear configuration. Slightly new engine configuration. It seems much more stable now. Definitely going down the runway at a good clip. Come on, let's slowly bring her up. Am I not going to be able to fly this thing? Bring the gear up. Yeah, we got a ways to go with this. It's so damn heavy with these engines on here and all these fuel pods. It's actually tough to lift it up with these. But, stability problem fixed. And now I think we can start working on those initial stage launcher. All right, so I skipped a little bit here. I've completely revamped our control surfaces. I've added more, including a full set of canards to the main body there. And now we can continue to gain altitude past 10,000. I'm still just testing altitude gain and stability. We're losing a lot of stability up here, though. Our efficiency is also very low, so I'm thinking maybe 10,000 might be too much. But we'll see what kind of speeds we can get up to at, say, around 12,000. One thing that I'm noticing now is that as I get higher up here, we're actually increasing our speed by quite a bit. It says our efficiency is down, but man, our speed is going up. We're almost at 500 meters per second, and we're climbing. So that's pretty huge. I think that this might actually be a decent configuration. I'd almost like to see how much further we can go with this, but I want to increase my horizontal stability, our roll stability, a bit because of how flippy-floppy we are up at this altitude. Either way, we've made a pretty significant discovery here, and that should help us and our program on the way to achieving our objectives. Alright, so in theory, this will increase our stability a lot. And I also think we're going to need either more engines. I think we might need to just add another set of these guys here. There we go. That's a shitload of engines, a shitload of fuel. And hopefully this will get us to the point where we can super cruise at altitude. Alright, I went and had a burrito, and as often happens with really good burritos, you have burrito-induced hallucinations. And my burrito-induced hallucination for this was that because of all the extra weight we've added, it might be possible to try these solid fuel thrusters again. Alright, okay. Looking good. Now we just gotta... Wow. Wow. That's remarkable. Not perfect. And who knows what's going to happen when I separate those and fire these other guys, but that was pretty good. So, something went wrong. Pop them off, and now we're firing our liquid engines. Let's see if they can even give us enough thrust to get up. We're going to start trimming. All right. Good, good, good. Good. Happy, happy. Whoa. Okay, we're a bit wobbly in the center there, but much better as far as our roll stability goes, it seems, than we were before. Okay. That seems pretty stable. So we're looking at 442 at 10,000. Losing speed. I'm just going to leave this for a little while and just sort of see how it does at this altitude and this speed. Okay. It's not good. Don't know exactly what happened there. I took a look at the globe for a second, and then this. So I'm guessing this isn't the most efficient way for us to spend our fuel. Let's see what happens when we jettison these. Hey, well, if we're doing a crazy roll, we can safely jettison those tanks. And our other stage burns properly. Oh my god, we just crashed into our fucking engines that we jettisoned and we lost half a wing! Oh, goody. Jorlin is excited about this predicament. I am not. I think we're going to go ahead and end this now. Alright, so this could be the beginning of the end of this aircraft. I've doubled the length of the wing. I've added a little bit more length to the wing. Just one extra slat there. And I've moved the engine far out, and I've removed one of the engines. I've moved our center of gravity far, far forward, but I still don't know if this is going to give us enough lift to make for a successful flight. And I may want to remove one of these sections to make the aircraft less long, but I don't know, because these sections are huge. They are... What are we talking here? Total mass of 1, so that's not bad. These guys have a total mass of 2.25, but they carry 400 capacity fuel, and these ones carry 150. I don't know. I don't think I need to change anything there, but we'll see. Anyway, if this doesn't create a massive increase in lift-to-thrust ratio and fuel efficiency and everything, we may have to completely design the wing using different parts, but we'll see. Okay, this is pretty much level flight, getting pretty close. We're tilting up just a little bit, but our speed is maintaining stable, and our altitude is jumping around just a little bit. We're tilted up just a bit. Let's tilt it forward just a smidge. That increases our speed. I think we can maintain a fairly level flight with this guy. The question is for how long? All right, we've got some relatively significant changes here. We've tilted the wings slightly. We've also added a jettisonable fuel tank to connect to these nacelles so that we can get a little bit of extra fuel. I might want to move those actually in. I think I will, actually. But here's where it is right now. We're up to the Pole Rubber Mark 7. And we're going to see what this thing can do. Oops, debris. That's always a good sign. Let's see if she's balanced. Pretty good. And I've got our stages set up. We're going to fire. These guys are going to jettison first. They're the ones being used first. So that's good news. And one thing that's interesting is that we added extra weight without adding any extra thrust in the form of these fuel pods. I just don't think we needed it. So we're going to let our wings do the lifting for now. I'm not going to trim it at all. I'm just going to let it lift until it starts to nose over on its own. I went ahead and executed our northern turn. So we're gaining altitude and speed still. Probably going to see what we can do at an altitude of around 10,000. Cruise north as far as we can go and see what we've accomplished with the Pole Rubber Mark 7. Because we haven't made a landing since the Pole Rubber Mark, what was it, 2? Yeah. We've got 1 and 2. We're all the way up to 7 without anything to speak of. So I think it's time for us to test our mettle, see what we've accomplished, and that is to see if we've accomplished anything at all. I am loving this high-speed cruise. Look at the distance we are putting under us as we go. We still have not gone through these two extraneous fuel pods as well, so I'm pretty hopeful about our progress. Here we are passing 15 kilometers above the Pole Rubber Mark 1, going twice as fast as it went, flying at 4 or 5 times the altitude that it was flying at. So, we still have not jettisoned these fuel pods yet. They are getting really low, though. They're down to 63 liters, but these ones still have 400 liters. What's going to be interesting is what the change to the aerodynamics of the plane will be when those are jettisoned, if any. Alright, so there's the Pole Rubber Mark II off of our right side, and we are down to 75 liters of fuel in the main fuselage. So we are running on 270 liters of fuel on each wing. Okay, our rear engine is completely shut off, and that's giving me some strange aerodynamic changes. So I'm going to have to try to get this sucker leveled out here. So we're only on our wing pod engines. And that is quite a view right there, is it not? Someday soon. Not Halley, though. Not this Halley. Maybe another Halley. It is going to be close. You can really start to see it now. But we have only got 100 liters of fuel left in each. We have achieved long-ranged suborbital flight. We have navigated 1/4 of the way around Kerbin. Maybe a little further. Maybe a little less. I don't know. But damn, it was good. Alright, we'll stick around for when the engines pop off. Because that's going to be a sad time. Because I've grown quite attached to not just the aircraft, but to this flight. I mean, this was an epic flight. It's taken me a long time in the real world to do this. And I love this sense of accomplishment that Kerbal Space Program can give you. Good night, sweet princes. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Holy fucking shit! That's not good. Uh-oh, turn off the SAS. Oh god, the wings are gonna rip off. What the fuck? Oh god. What in the fuck is going on? I can't stop it. I can't trim out of it. Come on, trim all the way, you bastard. Oh god. The fucking wings just fell off. Whoa, 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 whoa. Come on. Give me something here. Give me something. Okay, 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 okay. We stabilized a bit. I don't know if we can do this without exploding. I don't know if we can get this on the ground without it blowing up. I'm trying to trim it as best I can. What the hell was that noise? I think one of the wings... Oh no, that's a siren outside my house. Okay, we're dropping like a rock. We have a little bit of lift because of these wings, and I've trimmed it out as best I can. So we're either going to crash or we're not. You know, I had never thought of the possibility of completely jettisoning those wings and using this as like a landing craft. Or even maybe like a low altitude burn craft, because this would only be able to do this in thick atmosphere. Maybe that's what happened, was without the thrust up at that at altitude, the atmosphere was just too thin. One of the other problems you have with landing up here is it's really tough. We're at 1,000 meters right now. I can't quite see where the ground starts because it's got like no tech. I can start to see it. Alright, I'm seeing it. I'm seeing it. I don't even know what direction we're heading. We're not heading north though. I know that. After that fucking crazy tumble. Hallie, do you believe in me? Do you believe? I'm not sure if I believe. Oh my goodness. Wow. It's almost like I designed it on that way on purpose, but I didn't. Here we are. And whatever that is. Okay, well, I'm not moving, so the apoapsis there is ridiculous, but still. A heck of a jump. And I think that's something we can hang our hat on for suborbital flight. I think we've spent enough time with it, and I'm pretty freaking happy with what we've achieved. So, in that end, we are going to get Hallie Kerman out of here. She'll never be able to get back in, but here she is, able to watch this thing float away. Please stop sliding. That's not helpful. Okay, she bonked her head into it, and now it stopped. Continue bonking your head into it, it's doing it again. I don't think we can jump up high enough to get back in this thing with the jetpacks. Let's see. Nope. The latch is all the way up there. Ow. Alright, well, Hallie, you are the first Kerbin that I'm aware of from my own program to make it this far, and here you shall stay. For all time. Let's go ahead and go to the Space Center, and we'll look at the Space Tracking Station. So here we can see the progression of our terrestrial travels from the Kerbal Space Center to the Pole Rubber Mark 1 landmark, to the Pole Rubber Mark 2 landmark, to Hallie Kerman landed really freaking close to the freaking North Pole. There's no way we're ever going to fly to the North Pole and back or completely circumnavigate the globe without using some kind of mod parts or without the system changing completely. But I'm really happy with what we've accomplished there, and I think we're ready to move on now that we've, so to speak, conquered Kerbin. We're ready to try and conquer the outside of Kerbin and then maybe even the Moon.